It's 2:30 in the morning.
The arsenal that was going on, and the kid peed on a fuse that was going to like blow up something in the city or whatever. Guy kicked us out.
Oh yeah, we didn't miss the bus. The guy kicked us out. So here we are again at the start of another vlog, and I forgot to do the intro. I should not be allowed to be vlogging anymore. Anyway, it starts off with me leaving Hamburg, and I'm on my way to Belgium to visit my friend.
It's currently 2 a.m. and I'm at the airport, but I'm getting a flex bus. I just got a hot chocolate and a pension at 2 a.m.
Good morning, everyone. So I just arrived in Ghent. We actually got here 10 minutes early, so I'm just gonna sit here and wait for my friend to come pick me up. You've probably seen him before actually in some of my videos, but yeah, we were in uni together, so that's who I'm visiting. Now we're here. Well, now I'm here and I'm just gonna wait for a bit. I'm so tired actually, because I traveled from last night at 6:30. And now it's like 8:15 and finally here. Luke is across the road. It's Kenzie. Hey!
What up, dude?
Hi everyone. So I'm currently with my friend now while he's inside there looking for something, but we're gonna go sightseeing now. There's a fire alarm going off for some reason, but yeah, we're gonna go sightseeing. I think we're gonna start off with the castle. We're not sure yet. We're just trying to figure out where we're gonna go, but we're gonna stay in Ghent for today, and then maybe tomorrow we're gonna try Brussels, and I'm super excited. A babysitter. Apparently this is a library. That's so cool. We just stopped here to proper fangirl at a library. We're nerds. We're really nerds. But this library is actually very, very cool, and it has a really beautiful view, so.
Guess where the next light's gonna be?
I don't know. Where are you gonna press?
Well, that's the name of the game.
Okay. Guess.
Yep.
There.
Oh, that was close.
That was so close.
Is that the one you picked?
I picked this one. And then this one lit up. That was really close.
You have two more tokens.
Okay. That one.
This one here?
Yeah.
One last token.
Okay, that one.
Not bad.
Not bad.
Not bad.
So after walking around the city, Kenzie and I decided to stop at the Gravesteen Castle, or the Castle of the Counts. It was actually quite nice. We did the audio tour and the guy who was narrating was a comedian, so it was quite funny but also informative. Hi, Kenzie. This was a view of Ghent from the castle, and honestly, it was breathtaking. So this room had the top five executions that took place in the castle, and it was just paintings, and the guy was just explaining everything that had went on. This was a dungeon where people were tortured, and then the next part we saw the toilets. Afterwards, we went to this place called Chocolates for some waffles and beer.
So we just finished at the castle, and now we are stopping here for some Belgian waffles. Kenzie's just putting in an order for us, and then we're gonna sit here and enjoy them together. The weather is quite nice, it's quite warm, very nice. We haven't seen much sun in Germany in a while, so this is nice. And then I'll show you the waffles. This place is really, really cute as well. This is quite nice.
Interesting.
I don't know if you want to have a... You can't really taste anything. It's very, very delicious.
So how's it different?
It's a cherry beer. It's quite good. It's very nice. It's flavorful. It's refreshing. It's perfect for the warm day. Mm. 8.5 out of 10. That's a good rating.
So afterwards we stopped for some Belgian fries, and I'm not really a fan. And then we walked back to Kenzie's place where he made us burgers for dinner. And Chef Kenzie in the kitchen making us some burgers. So on the Saturday morning, Kenzie and I had breakfast, and then we took a train from Ghent to Brussels.
That one?
Two.
Are you? So we are in Brussels today. We just got off the train and we had the most dramatic dramatic train situation, because we were like about to get onto the train only to discover that the train is going in the wrong direction, and they changed the platform. They changed the platform at the very last minute. So here Kenzie and I were running towards like a different platform to try and get to the train, but thankfully we're here and it looks beautiful actually already. Yeah, so come along.
So, We've arrived by one of the main attractions. It's that guy right over there, dressed in, I don't even know they even put clothes. I don't even know how they put clothes on that guy.
He
usually doesn't wear clothes. But the story is that that kid's famous because back in the day, he like there was like a war, a disaster that was going on. And the kid peed on a fuse that was going to like blow up something in the city or whatever, some random boy walking by. And yeah, he saved the city because whatever bomb or cannon, it didn't go off. I don't know why the enemy didn't just relight the fuse.
Honestly.
But, and then the other story is that he's a kid that was bewitched and frozen in time. I don't know what he did, but yeah. But people just love him.
For some reason, there's a huge crowd.
But we'll never know.
We'll never know.
So we spent most of our time in Brussels just walking around, sightseeing a little bit. We had a quick stop for iced coffee, and yeah, we just basically walked around and explored the city.
Kenzie just discovered KFC, so he's getting one piece of chicken because he hasn't seen KFC since he's been in Belgium.
Dude, I saw KFC in Versailles. In... Man. I have to. I don't even need this burger.
I feel like, yeah, it's okay. Just do it.
Ghent is, I don't know what those guys are doing, man.
You don't have a KFC in Ghent?
I don't know. I haven't seen one. Dude, I even...
So... Out of 10? Oh, really?
Tastes like home, dude.
So this is how you travel on a budget? You pack sandwiches.
So we left Brussels Central to go to Brussels Midi on a quest for, believe it or not, spices.
We're honestly not having much luck trying to find the spice, and none of them speak like English, which is understandable. They speak French. But now we're just like searching through the spice to try and find the spice that Kenzie needs. Lots of paprika, I'll say that. Lots of spice options, but not what we want.
They have very interesting Fanta flavors. This one is elderflower, lemon, strawberry, and kiwi. And then there's lemon. And this Schweppes drink that looks pretty interesting, actually. I feel like I should try some of these.
So we're back in Ghent, we just got more waffles. Kenzie got waffles. His waffle with cream, I got powdered sugar. We just missed the bus.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm gonna use...
The guy actually kicked us out.
Oh yeah, we didn't miss the bus. The guy kicked us out because we had waffles.
Did you see him look at the spice pack? He was like... Mm-hmm. So I asked him, like, is this, like, fine? Is this the right one? Knows I can't speak French. Said something, and he put it on the side where you're supposed
to... I think that cat, that dog is seeing itself for the first time.
That dog is like, nah, man.
Like, what is that?
Oh!
This is scary.
I wonder how long he's gonna stay there.
Probably
have some KFC. Well, we both did. Also, yeah, KFC for dinner.
Hola. So today is my last day in Belgium. I'm just making some breakfast now. I'm only leaving in the evening, so we still have like a full day to do things. We're gonna go for a boat ride and just follow along for the day. Just making some scrambled eggs, bacon and toast for breakfast and some coffee. And we're gonna be on our way.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah.
Actually pretty low, like the water's like right here with Kenzie. It's very hot actually, but it's only like 24 degrees.
Gee, cool man.
It is cool, it's just very very low, like
look at the grain staple house, for example, where it was stopped and left to die all the grain that came from crops. And you see a layer of 40 skins cooking from the second one, the Roman, and the next dog litter, dog in the social lineage, the name of the year. It's important for a dog and the intensive skin. C'est l'un des canaux du séparatisme de
like your chocolates?
They're good, dude.
So my Belgian trip has officially come to an end. I just finished packing and then we're gonna head to the train station. I mean to the bus station because I'm taking a Flixbus back home again. So yeah, it's been really nice, but we are kind of in a hurry and kind of running late. So we need to leave like immediately. Fingers crossed. Everything goes well. So I just made it to the Cologne Bonn airport. So I just have to wait here for like another hour and a half. It's 2:30 in the morning. The bus got here like 20 minutes early. I don't know how I was driving, but okay, it's fine. We made it. Now I just have to wait for like another hour and a half. And I have to get on another bus. I'm missed the train from Hamburg to where we stay. Well, not really, because I still need to take the bus. But yeah, it came early, so I was kind of confused as to whether I was supposed to get in or not. But now I'm in, so all good, I guess.
And that is it for the Belgium vlog. Thank you so much for watching until the very end. I hope that you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye. Angel, sing from above. Every day, Lord, sing.